always roll and the wind never stops. Now this is our town, baby, you and me. It takes a little time, but soon you will see. We got clothes on the line, blowing in the breeze. The kids on the wharf, skipping rocks in the sea. The people are friendly and the children are free. Yeah, our little town is just heaven to me.
Welcome to This Week in Review. Tonight's stories include the third annual Books for Babies party, Good Season for the Minoraki, Tuesday was Pancake Day, these stories plus the BBS Playbill, Off the Rack, and more coming up after this. On Friday, February the 24th, the public library held its third annual Books for Babies party. 18 invitations were sent out for Books for Babies party. 12 children and their parents or guardians attended. As with previous years, the children were divided into groups. The first group went to the Resource Center. Here, Michelle Mercer and Lisa Durnford read a story to the children, sang a few songs, as well as did a coloring page that will be included in a book.
MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O, and on his farm he had a pig, E-I-E-I-O, with that oink oink there and oink oink there, here oink there oink everywhere oink oink, oh MacDonald had a farm.
Group number two did their activities in the library. Donna Warren and Renee Mead helped this group play a series of matching games, such as putting the letter on the book, the worm on the apple, and the bee on the beehive. The child who came closest to the X on the back of each of these items won a prize. There was also a pencil game, where children drew a pencil out of a bag, and the child who got the pencil with the black mark on it won a prize. They also played a fish game. Here the children caught a fish and had to do the activity that was written on the back.
Sarah, in all your fingers.
The children also made a headband with books for babies written on it. A lunch was provided by the library board. The winners of the pencil game were Andrew Clodger and Nicholas Lushman. The letter game was won by Zoe Clodger. The worm game was won by Nicholas Thompson. Marissa Warren won the beehive game. The prizes won by these children were either books or plush ducks. The library bag door prize was won by Andrew Clodger. The children seemed to enjoy their books for babies party. The librarian, Mrs. McDonald, informed us that there is a Book for Babies conference coming up in May. Michelle Mercer and Krista Standing will be representing Burgio at this conference. It would seem that the minor hockey is having a good season. For many years, the minor hockey league had problems with getting time on the ice. This is not so this season. With the roof over the rec center, the temperatures below zero, and a good ice surface, things are in full swing for the league. We dropped by on Saturday, February the 25th, to get a few clips of the two Adams boys teams playing against the Burgio Storm girls team. Many parents and grandparents were sitting in the bleachers enjoying the game. When we arrived, the first game was almost finished. However, we were just in time to catch one of the teams scoring a goal. Just minutes later, the other team scored a goal. The game finished with a score of 3-1 for the Adams team. The second game began shortly after giving the girls team a break. During the break, we got a chance. Once the ice surface was clean, the second game got underway. Adams' team were the younger members. Even though they were younger, the skating skills of these boys were very impressive. These boys seemed to be really enjoying playing a game of hockey. We spoke to one of them before the game began.
How are you? What are you doing up here today?
What are you doing?
I'm going to watch from here.
You going to play some hockey after, are you? So you might be the yellow team, are you?
Yay!
Oh, okay. So you playing? Yeah. Are you playing with girls?
Yeah.
Are you playing with the girls?
Yeah.
That's the Burgio Academy team, is it?
Yeah. It's girls hockey team.
Girls hockey team.
Yeah.
Is it the same as the girls floor hockey team?
Yeah.
Yeah. Are they any good?
Yeah.
Yes?
Nah.
No.
With the rec center in full swing, all of the minor hockey teams are getting plenty of practice. As long as the temperatures remain below zero, the ice will be good for all the activities at the rink center. Why not drop by the rec center to pick up a schedule and see what the rec center has to offer? Tuesday, February the 28th, was Pancake Day. Pancake Day is also known as Shrove Tuesday. Pancake Day is a day before the beginning of Lent. Pancake Day came about because households had to use up their supplies of fat, butter, and eggs before the first day of Lent. These items were considered forbidden during Lent. Pancakes was a simple way to use up all of these ingredients. This tradition is still kept today, mostly for the children in the family. Some families still include a game with their pancake meal. In their pancake batter, they include a money, ring, and a nail. Whoever gets the pancake with the money will be rich. The ring means you will be getting married, and the nail means you will become a carpenter. This tradition is still popular, even if the children in the family have all grown up. Even adults like to enjoy a meal of pancakes. We hope your pancake day was enjoyable. Stay tuned for more of This Week in Review coming up after this.
6 months ago, she didn't know what kidney disease was. Today, it affects every aspect of her life. Hours of dialysis don't leave much time for bedtime stories. She misses weekend camping trips. She misses family pizza night. And her daughter misses them too. Through research and patient services, the Kidney Foundation is helping to create a better life for patients and their families.
Wednesday was the first day of March. Many of our residents thought about an old saying. The saying goes like this: if March comes in like a lion, it goes out like a lamb, or vice versa. If March comes in like a lamb, it goes out like a lion. The first day of March in Burgio began with a temperature of -3, overcast skies, and very little wind. The afternoon temperature was -1 with sunny periods and still very little wind. By 2:40 p.m., the temperature was once again -3 with overcast skies. According to the old saying, I guess we can expect March to go out like a lion. March the 1st was also Ash Wednesday, the first day of Lent. It is a 40-day period when Christians reflect and do a self-examination on their spiritual life. This belief is based on the 40 days when Jesus went into the desert where he fasted. Because of this, it is custom for everyone to give up something in Lent, especially sweets. This tradition is not quite as popular in these modern days, times. However, some people still give up things for Lent and take them up again once Lent is over. The most common thing to give up seems to be chocolate and candy. If you gave up something for Lent, then we wish you every success. Stay with us for Off the Rack and the BBS Playbill, all after this.
They say if you want a wish to come true, never tell anyone. But there is one wish that can make the difference between life and death. And this wish can only come true if you tell someone. Please let your family know you want to be an organ donor.
Off the Rack. This week, as we scanned our tape rack, we came across a tape with film footage of ice at Granny's Brook. Let's look back to March the 3rd, 1996.
100 drums are drumming down along the briny shore. My heart knows what they're saying. Get in step and follow me, boy. It's a song that they've been singing for 1,000 years or more. To me, say, come, my son, I'll show you things you've never seen before. Come, set your spirit free on the winds of history. Hoist your sails and chart your course and go out and explore. Oh, the rolling of the sea is beckoning to me. Come home to Newfoundland and Labrador. Well, I've always been a rover,
I never found. Now I hear the ocean calling with a voice so loud and strong. Come on back to Newfoundland, that's where you belong. Hoist your sails and chart your course and go out and explore. Oh, the rolling of the sea is beckoning to me. Come home to Newfoundland and Labrador. The rolling of the sea is beckoning to me. Say, come, my son, I'll show you things you've never seen before. Come set your spirit free on the winds of history. Hoist your sails and chart your course and go out and explore. The sea is beckoning to me. Come home to the land of Labrador.
VBS Playbill. Try your luck on Wednesday by playing Elk Committee TV Bingo. On Thursday, we will have a rebroadcast of the Wandering Jamboree. And I'll be here again next week with This Week in Review. Please stay tuned now for the Wandering Jamboree. For This Week in Review, I'm Marie Rose. Good night and God bless.